As usual, we're back on the highway headed north to meet up with Top Chef star Kenny Gilbert at his popular and oh-so-delicious Gilbert's Underground. Gator and dumplings. I knew I had to come to Florida and eat some gator.
Oh, yeah, for sure. This is pulled smoked gator rib meat, pimento cheese dumplings.
Wow.
And has a little smoky sauce that comes with it, some braised fennel peas.
It looks so good. I wanted to ask you, you know, mm-hmm. when we're traveling around, we're always looking to see what the locals eat. But I kind of got the feeling that Florida's a little different.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about the cuisine here.
Well, Florida, there's a lot of transplants that live in Florida, coming from all over. It's very, not that often that you actually find someone that actually is from Florida.
Right.
There's a lot of influences from South Carolina, South Georgia. And really, when you hit St. Augustine to me is where it really stops
right. For
your true Southern influences. You know, so really St. Augustine on up and then all the way across the Panhandle to me is what really quantifies Southern cuisine. You know, and you know, through the immigration and the slave trade, that's where all the core influences started originally. You know, you have the Spanish, you have the English bringing over the slaves from Africa. You know, as they're hitting through the Caribbean, they're bringing different things with them on these boats as they're making different stops. Then boom, they hit, they settle in St. Augustine, you know, and then you have the Native American influence. So all that makes up what our food is.
Mm-hmm.
So to really classify what Florida cuisine is, it's really coastal.
Yeah.
And then you have a lot of alligators all around. So when you look at a lot of the history books, you'll see Native Americans, you'll see Spaniards, you know, spears and everything, and you'll see these big fires, and then you see these gators on these big spits. And so a lot of the original barbecue in Florida was based on alligator and a lot of fish.
Are you doing anything in the kitchen that maybe I could watch you cook up?
You know, I think I'll take you back there and show you how to make that Fernandina Beach hot chicken.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that would be special. Let's do it.
All right.
Fernandina fried chicken, I love it.
Yeah, the fried chicken is taking a life of its own. That's definitely our number one seller on the menu. It's just comforting, it's something easy to share, and that's the whole idea of our concept here. We wanted something very casual, very local and regional for people to enjoy. So we're gonna add in our chicken seasoning, and then we add in just a little bit of Cajun. And then from there, we just do a little mix. I take the chicken right from the brine into the flour and I roll it around. So you already see how it's starting to get a little tacky, right?
Yeah.
That's gonna help it become really crispy.
And from there, Chef Kenny fried the chicken for about 5 minutes, pulled it out, rebreaded it, and stuck that chicken back in the fryer. All the while preparing his signature special spicy sauce. Finally, the chicken was ready.
So at this stage, I'm just gonna dunk the chicken right in.
Wow, Chef, that looks so good.
Yes.
That is Southern comfort food at its best with your own twist on it there. Wow,
so
look at that.
We're gonna let that sit right here for a second, and we're gonna get our plate ready to go.
Okay.
So we put the bread down, and then we're gonna put some dill pickles down. And typically, hot chicken, you're always gonna have some kind of pickles, and you're always gonna have some bread because you need that bread to kind of to soak up that oil.
Got it.
And then from there, we take some of our pickled cherry peppers, and I like just kind of put it right on top. And then we take some scallions.
I don't know if they're ever gonna invent scratch and sniff TV, but if you could scratch your TV and smell this right now, you would love it. It smells so good.
And then we shake some of our Raging Cajun on top, and then a dab of prepared remoulade, and there you have our Fernandina Beach hot chicken.